Hi guys, this packaging contains the Hioki IR4056 insulation and continuity tester. This one belongs to my brother, who ordered it brand new from Amazon online. He sent it to me first for testing, for acceptance testing, if you will. Let me do a quick inventory first to check whether the contents of the package is complete. So far it looks to be complete. There are no visible damages. The operating precautions. The Korean user's manual. Unfortunately, there is no English user's manual. Test leads are included. The black test lead, the red one, the alligator clip, just one alligator clip, the red and black test pins, carrying strap, and the sealed battery. So far, the contents are complete. In this video, I will not cover the broad subject of insulation testing, but I will take you on a walkthrough of the IR4056 parts and functions with some simple tests. This should give you an idea of the capability of this instrument when it comes to insulation testing and how it may benefit you in your own work. You get 5 ranges of DC test voltages, from as low as 50 volts DC to as high as 1000 volts DC. Unless you're working on high voltage electrical facilities, these voltage ranges should cover for you most of the essential insulation test ranges. It has a backlight function, so you can clearly see your results in dim locations. This is a feature that you will surely appreciate for the convenience it provides. You get a voltmeter function. With this, you can check for the presence of AC or DC voltages in your test object or test subject before you conduct the actual insulation resistance testing. Remember that before conducting the insulation testing, the test subject must be totally de-energized and all its loads disconnected. Continuity function with 200 mA test current. This function will check whether your current carrying conductors or motor windings are still intact. While in the continuity function, you can use the 0 ohm adjust to set the internal resistance of the test leads back to 0. This is essential when measuring very low resistances, those values below 1 ohm. The lightning bolt symbol glows red to alert you when DC test voltages are being generated, or when in the voltmeter mode, the test leads are detecting AC or DC voltages. You can manually set a threshold using this comparator button. With this, you can make quick judgments of pass or fail during insulation resistance test or during a 200 mA continuity test. A safety release button should help avoid unintentional activation of the DC test voltages of the two upper level DC test voltages of 500 volts DC and 1000 volts DC. You first need to press this key in order to activate the 500 volts or 1000 volts DC test. Simply pressing the measure key does nothing. You must first press the release key. The Hioki IR4057 is powered by 4 AA size alkaline batteries, and the continuity function is protected by a 500 mA 1000 volt dedicated fuse. Safety warnings are also printed at the back, including important information on the insulation resistance ranges and the category rating of 600 volts. Based on the serial number of this particular unit, we know that this was made in Japan in March of 2023. This particular unit is barely 1 month old, so very new and very fresh. Hioki provided this nylon strap that you can pass through this strap, 4 strap holes, allowing you to hang the instrument by your neck, leaving your hands free to do the measurement. Here is my Hioki IR4057 with the straps already installed. for reference. They provided a space here on the upper half of the case so that you can neatly organize the test leads, including the alligator clip, when the instrument is not in use. And you don't even have to remove the test leads on the input terminals while safekeeping them. The cover, while it cannot be removed, it can be slipped under so that it does not get in the way. While the main device, the main instrument itself, sits permanently on the hard case and cannot be detached. You get a pair of Hioki branded, very flexible, high quality test leads and test pins, including one alligator clip. They have the category ratings proper for the insulation tester. The test leads have extra long, gold-plated metallic tips with removable sleeves. Unfortunately, they included only one alligator clip. So I suggest you get one more alligator clip, an extra one, the red one, because you're going to need two alligator clips in many instances. For this demonstration, I borrowed my four other AA alkaline batteries instead of opening the sealed batteries that came with the instrument for just this demonstration. And as you can see, there's the 500 milliampere fuse rated at 1000 volts that protects the instrument in its continuity function. When you return the battery cover, make sure that you do not over tighten the screw. Checking for the integrity of the test leads while keeping the two tips in contact. Turn the selector to any insulation resistance test range and press the measure key. 0 mega ohms means that the test leads are in good condition and are intact. Testing for DC voltage in the voltmeter mode. That's 7.18 volts DC. Testing for AC voltage in this outlet, still in the voltmeter mode, 230.9 volts. Remember that when in the voltmeter mode and testing for AC or DC voltage, the measure key should never be pressed or should never be flipped up. What would the instrument display for a failed continuity test? For this demonstration, let's just say that I want that the winding resistance of my old electric fan here between the blue and the white wire to be less than 20 ohms. I will set the threshold then at 20 ohms and then test it. The instrument flashes red and displays a value above 20 ohms, that's 29.2 ohms, and the instrument makes a fail judgment based on the threshold that I set. Testing the insulation of newly installed circuits is good practice. Here I replicated a simple branch circuit. Ideally for a newly installed or newly pulled wires, with no damage to the insulators, the insulation resistance should be more than 100 megaohms. In fact, it should be as close as possible to the limit provided by the test equipment. In my case, this should be more than 2000 megaohms in the 500 volts DC test voltage. That's more than 2000 megaohms between line 1 and ground, between line 2 and ground, also more than 2000 megaohms. Sometimes insulators get damaged or deteriorated with age. However, it may not always show up as a problem during insulation testing, especially when they are dry. In this particular instance, I intentionally made cuts in the insulators of the green and the black wire. But the result of insulation testing shows that it is still a passing result. However, now I will wrap the portion with damages with a wet cloth to replicate water contamination. This should replicate a condition where, during rainy season, sometimes the breakers or the fuse in a facility would operate. Now I have a failed result between line 1 and ground, between line 2 and ground. Also a failed result. So it's possible that circuits would operate normally during good hot weather, but when it rains, breakers would trip. When a loss of insulation have been established, it should be corrected as soon as possible for safety of personnel and equipment. My national oven is de-energized now, so now I can do an insulation test between line 1 and line 2 on its power cord. For this one, I will select 250 volts AC test voltage with a comparator value set at 50 mega ohms, which is the limit that the 250 volts DC test voltage can go in terms of comparator value. So I selected 250 volts because the operating voltage of my oven is 230 volts AC anyway, and I do not want to subject this appliance to more voltage than what I deem to be necessary. And this is why you need two alligator clips. Hioki only supplies one, so I had to find my own, the red alligator clip. Testing for continuity first of the alligator clips. My battery state is good. 0 mega ohms, so I have continuity. Now line 1 and line 2 of the power cord. Greater than 500 mega ohms, so a very good insulation between line 1 and line 2 of my power cord. Next, I will do a line to ground insulation test between the receptacle plug and the metallic chassis of the oven. Here I have a wire temporarily connected to the metallic chassis to provide a good path to the black alligator test kit. For this one, I will select 125 volts DC test voltage with a comparator value of 20 mega ohms, which is the maximum comparator value that can be displayed by 125 volts DC test voltage. Now, why 125 volts? That's because the oven is operating at 230 volts AC, and the line to ground or line to neutral of that is around 115 volts, so 125 volts DC test voltage is safe enough. Line 1 to ground, greater than 250 mega ohms. Line 2 to ground, also greater than 250 mega ohms. This simple test has showed me that my nearly 12-year-old national oven still has excellent insulation resistance in its power cord, which I believe is a testament to its high quality. But suppose I measured less than the threshold values in insulation resistance, especially if the result were below 5 mega ohms, then that should already be a warning sign to me of possible loss of insulation, and that I should stop using the appliance, instead have it repaired to avoid the risk of possible electrocution from leakage current coming from the current carrying conductors to the metallic chassis of the appliance. Before I end this video, let me share a couple of things that I did not like. First, they only included one alligator clip. Two would have been much better and less inconvenient to the user. Second, They only included the Korean version of the user's manual. This is good for Korean customers, but they should have also included the English version, which is universally common to many people. Fortunately, it's available as a free download from the Hioki website. Nobody knows their equipment better than the manufacturers themselves, so I suggest that you read the user's manual well for safe and proper use of the test equipment. I have barely scratched the surface of insulation testing, and this insulation tester, the Hioki IR4056, has much more capabilities than I was able to show. How about the price of this Hioki IR4056? Is it a good value? My brother bought this for $165 from Amazon online around 2 weeks ago, and he sent it to me first for testing. Since then, the cost of the IR4056 has increased to around $199. But for me, this is still a good value when you consider that the Fluke and Megger branded insulation testers with similar functionalities cost hundreds of dollars more. So compare their values and weigh your options carefully. If you like this, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Stay safe.